Hello, sellers. Thank you so much for being online with us. We will now continue with the session. So before I could go ahead, I'm going to be placing a poll question in front of all of you for us to just get started. Please do take the poll and let us know which language you would be comfortable for this workshop. All those participating now, do take the poll. On which language would you all be comfortable, so that we know what your preferences are and we take it accordingly. Okay, I'll give it a few more seconds and then we can start off. Okay. Thank you for taking the poll, sellers. I'm just going to share the poll in front of all of you, just so that you all know that majority of you have asked for Hindi and English. So we will try to balance it for sure. Right. So before we could start, today we have our Amazon team, our Amazon experts from the cataloging team, who will be addressing all of you and giving you some of the best practices. A lot of topics will be discussed for all of you to get your catalog in the right place. Do stay till the end of session and enjoy. Over to you.
Hi everyone, a very warm welcome to all of you. This is our second series in the cataloging space where हमने आप सभी लोगों से feedback सुना था कि आपको Amazon cataloging team से एक session चाहिए where we'll take you through the style guides detail page पे कौन कौन guidelines होती है Amazon की आपके ASINs कभी visible नहीं होते हैं कभी कुछ in-house catalog team होती है जो उसके ऊपर action ले लेती है इमेजिंग गाइडलाइंस होती है जो कि क्लियर नहीं होती है और ए प्लस वी दिस सेशन और द सीरीज इज एन आउटकम ऑफ योर फीडबैक एंड वी स्टार्टेड दिस लास्ट मंथ एंड वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू दिस एज अ मंथली केडेंस वी सो दिस इज दिस सेशन इज गोइंग टू कवर एवरीथिंग इन एंड अराउंड कैटलॉगिंग विच इज टू डू विथ व्हाट कस्टमर्स कैन सी ऑन द डिटेल पेज So I'm Sonal and along with me there would be five other of my colleagues who will be with you for the next 1.5 hours. We'll brief you through the guidelines on the agenda. As you can see, we'll start from why cataloging is important. We'll take you through the style guides which will cover both the data related, which is your title, bullet point, ka style guides, imaging ka style guides. We'll talk about A plus content, जो कि enhanced brand content भी के नाम से भी जाना जाता है, and then at the last we'll bring you some of the new catalog guidelines, specially around country of origin, जो कि एक latest guideline आया है हमें government of India की तरफ से, and then we'll have good 30 minutes to handle your Q&As. The Q&A poll will be open at the end. So you can park all your questions. We'll finish our presentation and then we'll come back and answer everything that you would want us to. Okay, so I'll get started. Why is cataloging important? So there are three key parameters, right? A good catalog is the first thing which is required to make sure your product visible ho search ke terms mein. So whatever you have put from a pricing standpoint, inventory standpoint, आपने एक fast delivery के अंदर अपने catalog को mark कर दिया है by being a prime customer or being an FBA customer. But if your catalog doesn't come on the search page results, customer cannot go to your product. There is no way that it would be visible to the customers, and then the sales essentially is an outcome of as many as the product. So there are close to 100 million products on the platform. And the visibility of your product making out across all the competition is something that a good catalog can help you with. That's the simple, I would say, the fundamental of having a good catalog. How you ensure that all the right keywords, all the right descriptions are mentioned on your catalog so that in-house search engine, jo Amazon ka hai, wo aapke products ko index kar sake to bring it on the search pages. So that is the most important bit of cataloging to help customers identify or discover your product amid everything which is present on the platform. The second key thing on the cataloging is product consideration and brand trust. So typically kya hoga, when a customer is going to come on the website, they look at the search impressions and then they will look on the product detail page. प्रोडक्ट डिटेल पेज के ऊपर जाकर ही एक कस्टमर उस प्रोडक्ट का कंसिडरेशन करता है और इवेल्युएशन करता है टू सी वेदर दिस प्रोडक्ट इज मीटिंग व्हाट आई वांटेड टू बाय. दैट इज समथिंग दैट्स द पेज वेयर यू आर क्रिएटिंग एन इम्प्रेशन ऑन द कस्टमर्स माइंड ऑन योर ब्रांड एंड द ट्रस्टिंग फैक्टर ऑफ योर प्रोडक्ट. वो रेटिंग्स के टर्म्स में भी आता है, वो Q&A के टर्म्स में भी आता है, वो रिव्यूज के टर्म्स में भी आता है. बट without before all of these things, customer sees is what is the title of your product, what are the bullet points that you have used to describe the product features, and how your primary images are, how your secondary images are. All of these, when customer look at it, he or she makes a decision to buy your product. That's where your catalog again has a very, very important role. And then the last thing, of course, is when the first two things are there, it will definitely help you on the sales conversion. So it is not just about having, I would say, a right price, but catalog is your way to make sure jo offline store experience hai, you are giving everything that customer would want to know on that website details page. So it's a very, it has got a lot of importance. And it also increases when bringing in a very, very niche products or a very, very high ASP product. So that's how we have to make sure to have the right catalog when we are listing all of our products. Okay, so I already search ek ho gaya hai aapka element cataloging ke andar. इसमें आपका सबसे पहला पॉइंट होता है प्रोडक्ट कैटेगराइजेशन. सो व्हेन अ कस्टमर इज कमिंग ऑन द प्लेटफॉर्म, देयर आर टू ऑप्शंस फॉर द कस्टमर. एक ऊपर सर्च बार होता है व्हाइट कलर का, आई एम श्योर आप सब लोगों ने देखा होगा. वहां पर कोई भी प्रोडक्ट सर्च करने के बाद जब हम डिटेल पेज पर जाते हैं या जो सर्च रिजल्ट आते हैं, एक पाथ दिखता है एट द टॉप ऑफ इट विच इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोडक्ट कैटेगराइजेशन. दिस इज टू मेक श्योर दैट इफ यू आर लिस्टिंग how do I say, adapters or a USB cable, you are making sure that you are placing it in the right category. Placing sari as a product in sari category and not kurti as a category. That is going to have a very, very significant impact to make sure that you are making your products visible. So what happens at the back end if this categorization is not done rightly? आपका प्रोडक्ट क्यों, बिकॉज आर सर्च एल्गोरिथम इज गोइंग टू पिक द प्रोडक्ट्स फ्रॉम दैट कैटेगरी, यू विल मिस आउट ऑन द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू हैव योर प्रोडक्ट विजिबल. सो देर आर मेनी कैटेगरीज दैट वी आर सेलिंग ऑन एट अमेजॉन एंड दिस इज समथिंग विच इज द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट फॉर यू टू मेक योर कैटेलॉग. ऑल द टेम्पलेट्स दैट वी हैव इन आर सिस्टम आर ऑल्सो ड्रिवन बाय द कैटेगरी. For example, if you are listing a clothing kind of a product, the template that you will have is going to be very different from when you want to go to the listing in electronics. Because the features jo hote hain in dono products ke, wo bahut zyada different hote hain. Aur isiliye ek right template download karna by selecting the right category is very important. That will allow you to make sure ki jo sare उस प्रोडक्ट के राइट एट्रीब्यूट्स है वो आप उसमें फीचर कर पाए. एंड देन इट अगेन हेल्प्स इन द रिफाइनमेंट्स जो आपको नेविगेशन के अंदर वेबसाइट पे दिखाई देते हैं. द लास्ट पार्ट इज ऑफकोर्स इमेजेस. व्हाई अगेन इमेजेस? व्हेन आई एज अ कस्टमर आई एम सीइंग एट टॉप रिजल्ट्स, आई सी ओनली टू थिंग्स ऑन दोस रिजल्ट. आई सी अ स्मॉल टाइटल एंड देन आई सी द प्रोडक्ट का मेन इमेज. एंड दिस इज वेयर आई एम क्रिएटिंग द फर्स्ट इंप्रेशन फॉर माई कस्टमर amongst all the competitive products which are coming on those results. So when I'll win the customer on that stage, that is when I'll migrate my customer from the search results to the detail page. And then again here, image ka importance hoga, title ka importance hoga, bullet point ka importance hoga, product description ka. So in dono evaluation ke baad hi customer ek decision lega to make sure that he's or she again is making the right purchase decision. That's where the importance of cataloging holds. This is our historic impact that we have seen. The right categorization, jo maine abhi baat kari, to ensure that aapka product sahi jagah par listed hai, that leads to roughly 1% conversion improvement. Bullet points and titles have a little higher impact because these are going to have you the right attributes available of the products. Images again have got their own impact, which is from 1 to 2%. And then this all will help you in getting customer to take the right purchase decision. So what are we going to do next in this session is to talk about these guidelines a little bit in detail, because hum samajhte hain ki ye थोड़ा सा डिफिकल्ट है वेबसाइट पे फाइंड करना. सेलर सेंट्रल पर ये सारी इंफॉर्मेशन अवेलेबल है, बट वी स्टिल सी दैट देयर इज अ गैप इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग. सो बिफोर वी जंप फर्दर इनटू दिस, कैन वी हैव द नेक्स्ट पोल क्वेश्चन टू अंडरस्टैंड जो हमारी सेलर कोहोर्ट है अभी वेबिनार के ऊपर, वो कौन सी कैटेगरी से लिस्ट करती है अपने प्रोडक्ट्स को. सो कैन वी गो टू द पोल प्लीज. Okay, so all of you could see the poll question on which category are you selling, entire Amazon fashion store, apparel, accessories, shoes, handbags, etc., etc., grocery, home and kitchen. This would include all of your furnitures, kitchen equipments, appliances, or anything besides this. We'll give you a few seconds. Okay, can we have the results, please? Okay. Great. So we have a good mix across all categories. It is around fashion, I would say, predominantly, and then electronics followed by the rest is all falling under others. Thank you for this. Can we also have the second question, which is on the average selling price of the product? Okay. So sellers, this is a question to understand average products jo aap sell karte hain platform pe unka price band kya hota hai. Less than 500 to 2500, up to 10,000 and then above. Okay, can we have the results, please? Okay, I can see the average price band is coming from 500 to 2500. Thank you. We can move back to the slides. Okay, what I'm going to talk now are the core components of catalog. Humne in sabhi ka importance ek overall customer level par understand kara hai. But this is a very quick snapshot of how your detail page looks like. The first one I explained, the categorization. Ye typically path hota hai jo aapko product ke top par dikhta hai. It could start from clothing, women clothing, again ethnic wear, and then kurti. That is going to be a full categorization. By looking at this, you can identify whether your product is sitting in the right category or not. We go towards the right. This is the title of the product. The first few, how do I say, words which described in crisp and precise way what the product is all about. Variations, you can see about the lamp and different colors visible, and then that is called bullet points. At the bottom, the product description. All these three components are mostly the textual attributes on your catalog, and largely this would impact your visibility and the discovery on the search results. Then there is also the imaging section. Again, the main image is visible as the big large image, and then the side tabs are the secondary images. All of the textual attributes have something called as mandatory attribute. These are the attributes which are marked in red cells on your template. And then one way or the other, they should come in your title or bullet point or product description. So this is will come next to one. This is to help again to summarize briefly what we are talking, going to cover in today's session, and the guidelines around it, which we recommend are the right ones. Okay, so how do we spoke in length about browse notes or categorization. This is internally called as browse notes. How do you find it? The left tab that you see is the first thing that you see when you're to download the product template. in this example, if I wish to list an inverter, I would start from appliances. I go to the kitchen and home appliances, and then I select inverter. What I get in the bottom section is the browse node. एक इंटरनल न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू होती है जिससे हमें पता चलता है कि प्रोडक्ट का नोडिंग क्या है. दिस इज व्हाट आवर सिस्टम इज गोइंग टू रीड एंड द क्लासिफिकेशन पाथ जो आप यहाँ पर देख रहे हैं अप्लायंसेस किचन होम अप्लायंसेस एंड इन्वर्टर्स इज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी विजिबल ऑन योर डिटेल पेज. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप व्हेन यू गो फॉर एनी प्रोडक्ट टेम्पलेट अपलोड और इवन अ न्यू इन्वेंट्री अपलोड. This is the path you should follow and make sure that you are doing the right category selection and you are getting the right node ID. How this impacts, I already spoke about it. Discoverability mein aapko ye help karega. So for example, agar main inverters wale section par hoon, which you are seeing on the red box, I can see only the products which are listed on this particular node ID. Any products, inverters, which are not on this node ID will not be visible when I am looking on the website via this navigation of inverters. Similarly, you can see there the refinements of brands. This is also going to be reflecting only on this node ID. If you miss, if there's a mistake or a mismatch on this versus what your actual product is, there's going to be, again, impact on the discoverability of your product. Moving forward, we'll come to style guides. Style guide is something which Amazon's category cataloging team jointly create to share what is the right recommendation for your product display. Simply put it, we do analysis of what customer is searching on the platform, what kind of questions do the customers ask. And again, what could be the best way to understand that product in an offline world? This three as a combination, doing extensive research is how we come up with the style guides. These style guides are something which are available in the PDF template on the Seller Central and clearly describes to you what should be the title, how the bullet points you should be leveraging. And then what could be the product description. The same style guides talk about the imaging do's and don'ts. So the yellow text, for example, you can see here is we are writing how your title should look like. Ye bahut hi simple format mein humne kara hai, which is A plus B plus C plus D, where A, B, C, D could be different attributes to be important. I'll show you some of the examples on this style guide to help understand this better. For example, if I'm the cookware as a product, इसके अंदर मुझे material type और उसकी capacity बहुत ज़्यादा important है. So, sorry for the gap. Okay. So for example, if this is a curry pot, it's not just the image part of it. I need to know कि इसका capacity 500 ml. Similarly, whether it's web storage, window storage, उसकी finished type की है. And whether, like again, whether it is a natural take or it is a combination of food, that is something which as a customer is very important beyond the size part of it. So we curate, hand curate these guidelines to make sure you are able to describe your product in the right fashion. So here is an example of a good detail page versus not a relatively good one. Okay, so the left. Sorry, I am having certain connection issues. You can see here the right image is not having a very good display of the model. Secondly, the product description is very, very verbose. There are only 3 bullet points over there which are not good enough for me to identify the products. And then there are certain irrelevant information present on the title for which I cannot, for example, best price or fastest delivery. This information to me as a customer is not good enough or evaluable enough to take this decision. So versus that, if I can simply describe my product as what brand it is, it's what is the fit type and what is the type of the dress, that is going to be a more powerful title for me. It should be short, crisp and good enough to convey all the information. So sincerely request you to follow the guidelines. Sometimes we do hear from the sellers that what are created titles were better versus guidelines. But as I explained, there's a lot of research which goes into creation of this style guide. बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है कि आप इनको देखें और इन्हें फॉलो करने की कोशिश करें. द लास्ट थिंग आई वांट टू टच अपॉन इज द प्रोडक्ट मैंडेटरी एट्रीब्यूट्स. दिस आर अगेन होल्ड इम्पोर्टेंस. द रेड ब्लॉक्स में ये बॉक्स वन का स्नैपशॉट है टुवर्ड्स द राइट साइड. और इफ यू आर बल्क लिस्टिंग टेम्पलेट यू विल सी सम ऑफ दीस कॉलम्स इन द रेड the red boxes. These are all mandatory attributes. Again, ye attributes kyun important hai? You can see on the website for a lot of products, there are this tabular form of listing about the products. Or there are comparison widgets when it is coming to electronics. This is being started now for furniture as a category. Very soon we are bringing up these pre-populated tables for our fashion as a category as well. This is something which will be automatically populated by the information which is available on the back end. And hence, agar aap ye information miss kar denge, to isse hoga ye ki kisi aur product ke liye to customer ko ye extra information dikhegi, but aapke product ke liye wo nahi visible hogi. Same thing goes in comparison widget. If you are missing out of any of those information, or if this information is not correct or accurate at the back end, एक इनकरेक्ट कंपैरिजन होगा एंड दिस वुड रिड्यूस इंक्रीज योर चांसेस ऑफ प्रोडक्ट रिटर्न्स. सो प्लीज बी वेरी वेरी कॉशियस अबाउट दीज थिंग्स. यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू एडिट दीज ऑन द फ्रंट एंड, मीनिंग कि आपको ये टेबल एडिट करने का ऑप्शन नहीं मिलेगा, बट इन टेबल्स एंड फ्रंट एंड हमें विजिट्स कहते हैं, इनकी इंफॉर्मेशन सारी की सारी बैक एंड डेटा पे डिपेंडेंट होती है. सो please ensure that you are filling all the mandatory attributes rightly at the back end to give the right customer experience at the front end. Another big thing is, if you do not fill information on the mandatory attribute whenever you are creating a new listing, your upload will fail and you will see this error code of 99001, and it will say that the value was not filled in and hence your listing is not going live. So these would be the two things watch out for you. Again, information not visible on the front end of the widget or upload not going successfully, the mandatory attributes could be one reason. Okay, the last one is where to find the style guides. Again, this is very simple. If you go to the Seller Central and search for the style guides, you will see. Can we please move to the previous slide? Thank you. So on the Seller Central, when you search for style guides, there's a window which opens up as a results. When you click on the style guide, the entire style guide page appears up. This is a list of every single style guide that we have created. And when you go on this, you can click on individual style guide and you will get the PDF which I showed on the first slide. So it could be a little difficult to identify on the right first page of the essential, but when you will follow this path, you can get to the style guide for the product that you are listing. As I said, we continuously keep on updating the style guide, so keep a watch out on this section. Whenever a new style guide is launched, aapko ek notification bhi aata hai email ke through, jahan par ye new guidelines display. Both options are there for you, going through the Seller Central or through the navigation or the emails that you receive from the catalog. Okay. With that, I would like to move to the image guidelines, and I'll invite Abhishek to take you through that.
Thank you, Sonal. Very good afternoon to all the sellers. I am Abhishek. I will be taking you through yet another very critical piece of the style guides, which are the images. जैसे कि आपको पता होगा कि images is the first thing that a customer sees for your product listing, and therefore it is very important to have very high quality images on the platform so that it influences and increases the purchase probability of the product. So before we move ahead, can we have the poll question on the images? We'll take a couple of seconds to answer this. Okay, can we have the answer on the screen? Oh, great. From the answer, it seems that most of you are really aware of one of the most important criteria for image guidelines, which is white background. Thank you. Can we move on to the presentation? Can we move to the next slide? Great, thank you. So like I said, images are one of the most critical thing, important pieces of a guideline. And we are going to talk about certain image guidelines which we have researched and which we have found out that customers really want to see. So before getting into the details, let me talk about the minimum standard technical requirements that every image has to follow on Amazon. Your image size should be more than 1000 cross 1000 pixels, and definitely more than 1000 pixels on the longest side. Your maximum image size should not be more than 10 megabytes. Your file format has to be in the form of JPEG, PNG or GIF. No PSDs or PDFs are allowed on the platform. The image color format or the color mode for your images should be standard red, green, blue, or the normal black and white format. Your best crop ratio should be in the form of 1:1 square image. It can also go up to 5:1 rectangular format. Now let me talk about the image guidelines in depth apart from the technical guidelines. So images on Amazon are of two kinds. One is the main image and the other ones are the secondary images. So main images essentially gives your viewers the first impression of your product. It is the image that is shown on the search listing page. So it is very important that you ensure that your main image is of really great quality and it follows the imaging guidelines to the T. Because aisa na nahi hone se aapki jo product listing hai uski ranking niche ho sakti hai. So therefore it is important to have your main images guidelines followed. Certain do's around main image guidelines are that your image should definitely have a white background. It should fill 85% of the frame width. Your main images should definitely be professionally taken. It should not look like an unprofessional photo, because agar aisa hota hai to aapki image ki quality kharab hoti and it influences your customer not clicking on your product. Also your main image should only display the things that is actually the customers are actually getting, and it should not have any multiple accessories around in the main image. In case of multi-packs, your main images should have all the components that's coming along with the product. Agar aap apne right side mein dekhenge, toh we have presented an example around Philips trimmer. This is a perfect example of a main image. It is on a white background. Ye puri 85% width occupy kar rahi hai. Jitne bhi accessories is product ke saath aa rahe hain, those are displayed very clearly to the customer, and it does not have any unnecessary or accompanying requirements with it. Now that we know the do's of main images, let's also talk about certain definite don'ts for the main images. This is very important, that your main images should not have text, logos, watermarks, watermarks on your images. Your main images should not have multiple views of the same product. एक ही प्रोडक्ट के डिफरेंट इमेजेस आपके मेन इमेज में नहीं होनी चाहिए. प्लीज डू नॉट यूज सेलिब्रिटी इमेजेस अनलेस यू डू नॉट हैव लीगल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स विद देम इन द मेन इमेजेस एंड इनफैक्ट फॉर ऑल द इमेजेस एज वेल. योर इमेजेस शुड नॉट बी यू नो ब्लरी, इट शुड नॉट बी पिक्सेलेटेड और इनकरेक्टली क्रॉप्ड. इट डिक्रीजेस द एस्थेटिक्स ऑफ द मेन इमेज. मेन इमेजेस शुड नॉट बी ऑन अ कलर्ड बैकग्राउंड और शुड नॉट बी अ लाइफस्टाइल इमेज बारिंग सर्टेन categories where you know it is important to show the main image with a lifestyle or a background where we actually show how the main image looks like. Your main images should not be on a visible mannequin. Please avoid that. And of course, pornographic and offensive contents are not allowed on the allowed for any of the images on Amazon platform. Now we quickly move down to the secondary images. Now secondary images are the images which you see as you know, as blocks below your main image. Now these images, essentially you should use it to depict a story to your customers. You should use the secondary images to show all angles of your product. You should use your secondary images to address the heights and scales and give a reference to the customers. You should use your secondary images to specify any standards or any specifications around your product. If there are multiple components coming around with your main images or there's a packaging involved, please use a secondary image to display that. Aap apne secondary images ko ek lifestyle image ki tarah bhi use kar sakte. You should use it to show your customers what your secondary images can actually do. So secondary images are really very important to create a story around your product, jisse ki aapke customers aapke product ke saath relate kar sake and should get the advantages clearly of using your product. The only requirement that secondary images has to follow is definitely that all the technical requirements which I spoke about in the first slide are met. Another very critical piece of your images is that you should have a professional photo shoot done for your product. ये इसलिए इंपॉर्टेंट है क्योंकि अगर लो क्वालिटी प्रोडक्ट और अनप्रोफेशनली टेकन प्रोडक्ट्स अगर आप प्लेटफॉर्म पे डालते हैं, इट डिक्रीजेस द एस्थेटिक्स एंड द क्वालिटी ऑफ योर प्रोडक्ट एंड कस्टमर्स आर नेगेटिवली इंपैक्टेड विद दैट. अगर आप देखेंगे ऊपर वाले ग्रिड और नीचे वाले ग्रिड को कंपेयर करेंगे, यू विल फाइंड दैट अ कस्टमर, योर कस्टमर इज मोर प्रोन टू क्लिक ऑन द इमेजेस दैट्स ऑन द दैट आर प्रोफेशनली टेकन रादर देन फोटोज विच आर जस्ट नॉर्मली टेकन एंड अपलोडेड ऑन द प्लेटफॉर्म. So it is really important to have professional photo shoots done for your product. Now we will talk about about a feature that we have on our Seller Central, jise aap use karke professional photographers se contact kar sakte hain for various imaging services. Aap ise kaise explore karenge? Aap Seller Central mein login karenge, wahan par aapko ek tab milega apps and services. Click on that, you will find explore services option within that in the drop down. Click on explore services, you will land onto a page jahan pe jitne bhi hamare sath service providers ne tie up kiya hua hai, which offers services in imaging, cataloging, account management and various other services. Wo aapko dikhenge sare service features. Agar aapko imaging guide services use karni hai, please click on imaging services. When you click on that, aap ek page pe land karenge jahan pe jitne bhi service providers hai wo sare listed aapko dikhenge. You can filter the service providers basis their reviews and ratings by sellers who have already used their services. You can also filter them basis the proximity to your location. So this feature, we will recommend that you should definitely try and explore the service providers listed on Seller Central to get professional photo shoots done. Before we move to the next slide, can we have the poll question on catalog defect report? Okay, can we have the answer please now? Okay, great. So majority of you are already aware of a catalog defect report. Can we move on to the presentation? And the defects shared via the catalog defect report. However, I see quite a few who are not aware of all the defect reports that we share with our sellers on a weekly basis. So I will take a couple of minutes to talk about that. So agar even if after following all the guidelines and you have missed on certain guidelines, our team ensures to share a weekly report via emails with individual sellers and also uploads this report in the seller central. ये रिपोर्ट इस रिपोर्ट को हम कैटलॉग डिफेक्ट रिपोर्ट कहते हैं. ये एक एक्सेल शीट होती है जो कि आपको ईमेल्स पे आएगी रेगुलरली ऑन अ वीकली बेसिस और आपके सेलर सेंट्रल में भी अपलोड होगी. ये सेलर सेंट्रल में आप कैसे एक्सेस करेंगे, प्लीज लॉग ऑन टू सेलर सेंट्रल. देयर इज अ टैब कॉल्ड रिपोर्ट्स, क्लिक ऑन रिपोर्ट्स. इन रिपोर्ट्स टैब यू विल फाइंड कस्टम रिपोर्ट्स इन द ड्रॉप डाउन. क्लिक ऑन दैट. आप एक पेज पे लैंड करेंगे जहां पे आपकी पुरानी सारी कैटलॉग डिफेक्ट रिपोर्ट्स भी अपलोडेड होगी और जो मोस्ट रीसेंट कैटलॉग डिफेक्ट रिपोर्ट है वो भी अपलोडेड होगी. आपके पास डाउनलोड करने का ऑप्शन होगा. जब आप उस पर क्लिक करेंगे तो एक एक्सेल शीट डाउनलोड होगी. ये एक्सेल शीट एसेंशियली आपके जितने भी एसेंस आपने लिस्ट किया और जिसमें कोई भी एक तरह का डिफेक्ट है वो सारे एसेंस लिस्टेड होंगे. कैटलॉग डिफेक्ट रिपोर्ट में टाइटल डिफेक्ट्स भी होते हैं, बुलेट पॉइंट्स डिफेक्ट्स भी होते हैं, प्रोडक्ट डिस्क्रिप्शन डिफेक्ट्स भी होते हैं और इमेज डिफेक्ट्स भी मेंशन्ड होते हैं. सो इट इज रियली इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू ऑलवेज कीप चेकिंग योर कैटलॉग डिफेक्ट रिपोर्ट इधर ऑन योर ईमेल्स और वाया योर सेलर सेंट्रल अकाउंट, सो दैट यू एंश्योर जो कि जितने भी आपके कैटलॉगिंग में डिफेक्ट्स है आप उसे सॉल्व कर सके. और जैसा कि सोनल ने आपको पहले भी डिस्कस किया था, अगर एक परफेक्ट कैटलॉग आपके परचेज प्रोबेबिलिटी को बहुत बढ़ाती है और आपकी सेल्स कन्वर्जन को बहुत बढ़ाती है. सो विद दिस वी कम टू एंड ऑफ style guides and cataloging. Now I will request Animesh, my colleague, to take over the presentation and take you through certain new features that's coming on the Seller Central for you to benefit. Thank you.
Hey, thank you, Abhishek. I'm Animesh and I'll take you through some new catalog validation innovations that are coming on Amazon. So the catalog defect report that Abhishek just talked about, it's a effective tool to connect with you, but it does come with its own churn. Amazon pehle defect identify karti hai, fir aapko ek report bhejti hai. Then you take your time to correct those reports and send it back, and Amazon again re-verifies. Now all this cycle can take more than a few days, and all this while your customers are exposed to defective information on the platform. And जैसे कि सोनल और अभिषेक ने काफी बार स्ट्रेस किया है, डिफेक्टिव इंफॉर्मेशन डज हैव अ नेगेटिव इंपैक्ट ऑन योर कस्टमर्स परचेज डिसीजंस. सो टू रिड्यूस दिस चर्न एंड टू एनेबल यू टू टेक फास्टर एक्शंस ऑन एनी डिफेक्ट्स दैट माइट अपीयर ऑन द कैटलॉग, Amazon विल सून स्टार्ट वैलिडेटिंग योर प्रोडक्ट डिस्क्रिप्शन एंड बुलेट पॉइंट्स ड्यूरिंग एसिन क्रिएशन और अपडेट, राइट? सो Amazon विल वैलिडेट फॉर थिंग्स लाइक phone numbers, email IDs, URLs, or any abusive keywords that might be present in the metadata that you try to upload during async creation or update. So there are two ways you can update or create asins today. One is through a 1x1 UI. Second is through a bulk upload. Agar aap 1x1 ke through ja rahe hain, then you can go to catalog, complete your drafts. Or complete your drafts mein, you can see all the defects that Amazon has identified. For example, in this particular slide, you can see an example of invalid product description. So Amazon ka ek error message bhi aata hai, which goes something like your particular attribute, in this case, the product description, has the following defects. In this particular example, the error message says that the product description has a few email IDs which are non-compliant with Amazon and should be removed before attempting a re-upload. Same agar aap 1x1 se nahi ja rahe hain, aap bulk upload se ja rahe hain, then you have to go to inventory, add products via upload. Wahan pe aapko ek third tab dikhega, which is called monitor upload status. After you have uploaded a bulk file, the message, you will get a message that tells you to wait for a few minutes while Amazon is processing your report. And once that message has changed to the processing is complete, you can go to monitor upload status. There you get an action called download your processing report, right? So you can download your processing report. Our processing report will be essentially be a replica of what you have just uploaded. आपने जो फाइल अपलोड किया है उसी का रेप्लिका होगा अलोंग विथ अ फ्यू एडिशनल टैब्स विच आल्सो शो आउट योर एरर मैसेजेस. जैसे कि इस पर्टिकुलर एग्जांपल में Amazon has figured out that the product description had certain your email IDs which should be removed. So अगर आपका email ID है तो वो error आएगा. अगर आपने कुछ external URL दिया है या फिर phone number या WhatsApp number दिया है, all those errors will be caught here and you'll be prompted to correct those errors and re-attempt and upload. So the main motive of this feature is to reduce the churn and complete that cycle in a few minutes instead of a few days, and to make sure that your customers are not unnecessarily exposed to defective information. So that is about the catalog validation piece. And I would like to invite Sonal to take you through some of the A plus content that we have. Over to you, Sonal.
Thank you, Animesh. Okay, so we'll cover next 15-20 minutes on the A plus part. This is the enhanced brand content. Okay, I'm having trouble with the slide transition, so if the presenter could help me with that. Okay, so before we get started, can we have the poll question on A plus to get understanding of how many of you have used A plus before? So it's a simple yes no question. We know today A plus is currently available only to brand registered sellers, so maybe some of you have not got a chance to use this before. Okay, can we have the answers? Okay, good. So more than 50% of you have used A plus. That's a good sign. For the rest, there is a good news for you to be aware. If you go back to the slides, so for those of you who would not be aware of what A plus content is, it's a combination of high quality images and description that you have got an opportunity. Amazon has got this as a unique feature to essentially replicate the offline selling or purchasing experience on the website. You can see here we have chosen an A plus content on Saffron. This is something which you would not expect, but it's a pure delight as a customer to see what this brand is all about. They have taken the efforts to explain their own story, and this is one section which helps you create a very big brand trust with your customers. So it can have your images, it could have your product details, your brand name, your logo, your product specific features. You essentially get to talk with the customers. So Abhishek did talk about using your primary and secondary images, mostly the secondary images, to do that conversation. But over there, you have the limitations on text not being present. There's a limitation on the size of the images. It is still not as interactive. And hence, A plus is something which we call as an enhanced brand content. And it has got its significance to leave that lasting impact for you on the customer. This is one section which definitely makes you stand your product above your competition. Moving on to the next slide. So again, as I said, one thing is today, so far, Amazon India had A plus only and only available for its brand registered sellers. This would be the sellers who have got a registered trademark for the products that they're selling. They would be expected to register with Amazon's brand registry team, which we will provide you with the link in case you're not aware. But what we had as a very, very big feedback from all of you, especially we saw that, right, most of you are selling in that range of more than 500 rupees as a product. And as an Indian customer, when I'm purchasing a product of that type, it is very important for me to get full surety that I'm purchasing the right thing. It becomes very important, especially for this high price products, to give them a detailed description, and that is the reason why Amazon has taken a decision to open A plus to all sellers. I just want to be very, very cautious here. This is not going to be done for 100% of the sellers immediately. We have certain limitations with the traffic that can be managed for the website, and we want to ensure that the processes and the product technicalities are ready for it. We are going to do that in a staggered phase-wise launches. If you have, whether you have the A+ access or not, you can get that to know by going to the advertising tab of your Seller Central page. So that is very important. Till then, we would, expect you to have little more patience. We are opening this up for all of you, but we would need just some more time at our end to be 100% ready for it. And we are currently doing a pilot by trying it with few sellers to start with. Okay, so quickly, why do I need A+ on my listing? We have here a very good example of a Bluetooth headphone. It is telling me more than what I would have known from the secondary images. Like, I can exactly know how this is going to be looking when I wear this earphone. Right, we have the example of the mobile experience, which comes again seamless, and we have an example of the desktop experience again. More than 80% of our traffic is coming today on mobile. So this, all of the A+ content or the features that Amazon brings up are brought up on the platform considering what customer is going to appreciate. So A+ in short helps you in reducing returns. More importantly, it helps you create a very good brand impact with your customers. So as you get a chance to do this, definitely bring it up on all your high ASP products. What we are going to talk next is some of the features of the A+, and then what are some of the guidelines, because as we spoke about in the imaging, A+ is another set where we want to be little more stringent on our guidelines. That's what we want to cover in next few minutes. This is a quick snapshot of different kind of features that are available on A+. There are 5 different templates that you can pick from. It's a combination of one main image or some of a small paragraph, or you could use highlighting the unique feature. The third one that you see, you can have 3 images of same size and a small description under that. You can use again an example of one main image, which is kind of telling you the unboxing instruction. So the most suitable feature custom template you can use, what is relevant to your product, again to maximize the story that you want to tell to the customer. Additional product and lifestyle images or the brand banners, if you are again a brand registered seller, you can bring this up on your A+ content. So as I said, Amazon invests very, very dedicatedly into A+, because we believe this is the most appropriate manner for bringing a customer delight. Today there are 5 templates, but there are going to be many more. On some of the features, we also bring in videos, but those come into the premium phases of A+. We are not yet there, but again, leverage this section to talk about your product in the most effective manner. With this, I'll invite Anusha from our A+. Expert team to walk you through the rejection reasons.
Thank you for that, Sonal. Hi, everyone. I will be walking you through the rejection reasons. So as Sonal explained, an A+ page provides you a platform to add detailed descriptions, high quality images, feature specific content, anything really to make your product stand out amongst its counterparts. Now what this means is that this is a unique opportunity for you to be as authentic and as honest about your product as you can be. Essentially, the A+ content feature is designed to help sellers and vendors boost traffic, conversion rates, and sales. And you can add your enhanced brand content to ASINs that you own or have an offer on. And this includes both parent and child ASINs. As I'll explain and demonstrate shortly, vendors and sellers' jobs are made very easy with the tool. being that it's extremely user-friendly and highly customizable with a range of templates at your disposal. There's also a manual guide that helps the users navigate through the tool. So even first-time users can feel at ease while exploring all the options available to them. So an A-plus page is basically the closest thing to an in-store sales or a retail experience on e-commerce. Just as we would examine a product in person, the A-plus page helps highlight everything a buyer would possibly like to know about the product. So keeping this in mind, we have certain checks in place to bridge the gap between a seller and a buyer as smoothly and as uncomplicated as possible. So you can look at the slide here. Any sort of claims such as recommended by or validated by has to be substantiated by a note in the text with relevant proofs and evidence. Such awards must also be granted in the last 2 years, and this is to stay as current as possible. Avoid making any bold claims or boastful marketing campaigns when you're presenting your product's features. Let the product speak for itself. Direct the focus of the customer to what makes it so good so that they know why exactly they should buy it. No note or text pertaining to or promising warranties or guarantees are allowed. However, with a new change in policies, which I'll elaborate on shortly, you are allowed to retain and or showcase your trademark symbols in images only, not in text. I would say an ideal A-plus page is about 55% images and 45% content. Like I said earlier, it's the closest thing that we have to an in-store experience. So good quality images are very important. Stamping them with watermarks or cramming them with minuscule text would only dampen the experience and probably make the buyer move on to a product that has a more aesthetically pleasing, overall visually appeasing page. A-plus is for driving sales and boosting visibility on Amazon site. So redirecting them to other pages and social media handles kind of defeats the purpose of that. And any attempt of that will be rejected. Subtly guiding the customers to arrive at their own conclusions will drive purchase decisions far more successfully than it would if you were to attempt to outright influence them by telling them how to make the purchase. So it would be ideal and beneficial to craft your content around that. Okay, so you have your high quality images and you have your well thought out product specific content. Now how you structure that is just as important. Remember that it's all in the presentation. Texts that are spilling out of their designated boxes or images that are pulled apart or shrunk to fit into a window make for a very unpleasant viewing. Grammar, font, crisp and appropriate language, all these things add to the experience. So being conscious about how you want to tell your product story is really helpful and really important. So like I said, there are some changes in the policies from what it was before. Products that are specific to any event can be highlighted in the content. For example, as you can see in the image, a Santa Claus outfit is directly related to Christmas, or probably a Krishna outfit for Janmashtami would be fine. However, referencing a red dress as a hot date outfit on Valentine's Day or a fancy kurta as your next Diwali attire is not allowed. If you want to upload your A-plus page in any other language that is in English, but your images are in English text, then you are most welcome to add them. Similarly, if you have images of your customers using your product, they can be a part of your A-plus, but this does not include their reviews or their personal opinions on the product itself. Remember, guide, not influence. Now I'll take you through a demo on how the tool looks and works. So when you get your hands on it, you will feel a little more confident in creating your own content. Apologies, I think there's... some issue with the audio. Let me just check. Sure, I'm just gonna walk you through it. Upon clicking the A+ Content Manager tool, you'll be taken to the dashboard. Choose the Create A+ Content option, which will redirect you to the page where you can draft your content. Enter the title of your project under the Content Name tab and select the language you wish to publish your content in. Scroll down and click on the module. You can select your desired module, and you can also have the option to add a banner image of your choice. Choose the right image from your folder and make sure to enter relevant keywords pertaining to the product so that it's easily recognizable for everyone who's viewing it. Add that, and now you can move on to the product description. Keep the content detailed yet crisp for an enhanced customer experience. And also make sure to save your content frequently so as to not lose your progress. The tool provides a range of customizable modules, like I said, that can be tailored around your product as you see fit, based on the structure that you have on your mind. The templates already provide information on the compatible image sizes and requirements, so you can prepare in advance anyway. Add the relevant keywords. Also, adding a key feature and explaining it further gives you an opportunity to shine a light on your product and let the customers know what makes it stand out when compared to similar products, and hence drive their purchase decision. Again, make sure to save your progress. Once you're satisfied, you can apply your ASINs in the next step by clicking on the Apply ASINs option. You have a choice of adding a single ASIN or to do a bulk upload, which is a new feature that's available to you. Once you add your ASIN, make sure that the content and the ASIN match. The little icon in the left is helpful in visually identifying the product you wish to add your content on. Once you're done, you can save again and you can move on to review and submit. Here you can see a preview of the content as it would look on the detail page, and you can make changes accordingly. If you're satisfied with what you see, you can click on submit for approval. And there you have it. That's how the tool works. With all this and the tool being free of charge, it's practically a steal. The tool is a great feature for anyone to take an advantage of, especially if it pays off in the form of sales and visibility. So hope this helped. And if you want to know more, you have the Seller Central page to help you and guide you anytime. Now join me in welcoming Sri Lakshmi to present to you the country of origin attribute. Shri, over to you.
Thanks, Anusha, so much for the insights on A+. Before we go into the next section, Malvika, can we please have a quick poll question? Okay, while the poll question is coming up, we are almost at the end of our session. We are going to be discussing about country of origin and the other legally mandatory attributes. The question and answer is also going to be open for you in a couple of seconds. Please do use that to start asking all of the questions you've had on the presentation so far. Malvika, can we please have the poll on country of origin? Folks, this question is about us trying to understand how many of you have already started filling country of origin attribute. It's a yes or no question. All right. Can we have the poll results, please? Okay, it's great to see 76% of you have already updated country of origin. Thank you so much for that. Last but not the least, I do want to take some time to walk you through the new changes that we've introduced in the template and the listing process itself, where based upon the Legal Metrology Act, government laws and regulations, we are now expected to display the country of origin of all the products that are being sold on Amazon. And for us to do that, we first require this information to be updated from your end. So, the country of origin attribute is now made required for all new listings. What that means is any products that you plan to sell going forward, you have to update the country of origin for that product on your listings page. We also very strongly urge each and one of you to go back and update country of origin for all the existing listings that you have, and also update the other legal mandatory attribute information for your new and existing listings. This is a requirement by the government, and it is very, very important that you update this information at the earliest to ensure that you are in compliance with all of the laws and regulations. Another important aspect is that the country of origin that you update, please ensure that it is accurate and it's the actual country of origin of the product, that it's either on the product packaging or that is confirmed to you by the manufacturer. Because this is a legal requirement, I'm reiterating it's very important that you update this information and that you also ensure that this information is correct and accurate. Now, if you have any concerns or if you are finding it difficult to identify what is the country of origin for your product, our recommendation is to reach out to the wholesaler or the manufacturer of your product, understand from them what should be the country of origin for the products that you're reselling and update the same. If you still have questions or if you still have doubts, then we recommend you to reach out to your legal counsel, understand from them what should be the information that you upload and update it accordingly for all your new and existing listings. As I said, country of origin is one of the attributes. However, apart from country of origin, there are other legal mandatory attributes that you are also expected to fill in, such as manufacturer, importer, and packer information. So, for example, if your product is not, the country of origin for your product is not India, and you're importing it from some other country, then you're also expected to provide the name and the contact information of the person or the entity that is importing that product. Likewise, if a firm A or company A is manufacturing the product, but then company B is actually doing the product packaging. Here, when we say product packaging, we are referring to the actual package of the product and not the Amazon packaging or the delivery packaging that you do before you ship your product to the customer. This is more like the packaging that the product comes in, the blister packs or the the boxes that the actual product like a mobile phone or a toy would come in. This is not the Amazon packaging. So if there is a different company that is doing the packaging, then you would also have to update the packer's information. If the actual product packaging is done by the manufacturer or the importer, then you can update either the manufacturer or the importer's name and contact information in the packer attribute as well. The third legal mandatory attribute is generic name of the product. This is the common name in which customers can identify your product. For example, if you're selling turmeric, right? Customers would also generally in their everyday life call it haldi, and that is probably the generic name that you can update for your product. So if you're having spice tea or Indian tea, the generic name there could be masala chai. The next legal mandatory attribute that we have is of course the unit count and type. This is basically the quantity of the actual product that the customer will receive. For example, if you are selling a pack of, let's say, a pack of dupattas, right? You'd want to say one as your unit and the type to be one count or one unit. Now, if you are selling a set, maybe a kurti set, which has a top, a bottom, and a dupatta, then it has three items in the set. Then in the unit count, you can choose to either call it one set or three pieces. So that's what unit count and unit count type is attribute is, you know, trying to capture. The next one is the item length, width, and height of the mesh, height of the product. Again, this is the item length, width, or height of the actual product, and not the final box or the package. So, for example, if you are selling a mobile phone, then you are required to provide the length, width, and the height, or the length, the height, and the thickness of the actual mobile phone, and not the final box in which the mobile phone comes in. Likewise, for item weight, this is again the actual the weight of the actual item and not that of the packaging. Finally, we also have the expiry date or the expiration date. Now, this is applicable to all consumable products such as beauty products, groceries, and beverages and things like that, which typically have a defined shelf life. So the date that you would again update there is the earliest expiry date for that entire lot that you are selling on Amazon. There are Seller Central help pages on these legal attributes. The link is provided. Please go to the Seller Central page, go through the attributes in detail, understand their definitions, look at the sample values to know what kind of information you need to go back and update on your existing listings as well as your new listings. Like I mentioned earlier, these information is required to be provided by you as part of a government regulation, and it's very important that you update all of this information, especially country of origin, as soon as possible for all your new and existing listings. Update the accurate values because this is legal information, if you provide any incorrect information for any of these attributes, then again, you would be non-compliant with the law. So please keep in mind and update the correct information as soon as possible for all of these attributes. I will just quickly walk you through how to do these updates. So for a new selection, if you are listing products one by one, you would go to the inventory tab, add products, select the category for which you want to create the new listing in. And in the vital info tab, you will see an attribute called country of origin. If you click on the empty field, you will get a list of dropdowns which has all the country names. Select the appropriate country, update all the other required information and create your listing. Now, if you've already have an existing listing and you want to go back and update the country of origin, then you need to go to the inventory tab, select manage inventory. Under manage inventory, go to the SKU where you want to update this information. Click on the edit button. Once you click the edit button, it takes you to the 1x1 interface. Again, go to the vital info tab, select or scroll down to country of origin, and in country of origin, click on the dropdown, identify the country you want to update, select the country and then save your upload. So this will ensure that your existing selection also has country of origin updated. If you have a lot of listings and you want to do this activity in bulk, then you can use the bulk update UI. Again, go to inventory, add products via upload. Select the product or the applicable products to generate the required bulk template. Once you have the bulk template, fill in the SKU, fill in the product type, the corresponding product type for that SKU. Go to the attribute called country of origin. You will again find a drop-down experience here. Select the correct country and for each SKU, repeat these activities, input the SKU, select the product, select the product type, select the country from the drop-down, and in update or delete tab, make sure you select only partial update. This is very, very important. Select only partial update in the update or delete tab if you're trying to update country of origin for your existing ASINs. Save the file as a text tab delimited format. Upload your inventory file like you would do for any other attribute. And there you have it. Your country of origin will be updated for all your existing listings in bulk. Two things to keep in mind when you are doing the bulk update. Always ensure that the product type matches the SKU and it needs and the product type that you update here should be the one that you initially used when you were creating this SKU. Also, in the update and delete, make sure you always select partial update. So this is all we have about country of origin and the legal mandatory attributes. If you have any doubts what to fill in this, please reach out to your legal counsel and get their opinion and get their advice before updating any of these values. So we now quickly move on to the Q&A session. I would request all of the presenters to come online.
Okay, hi again everyone. We are receiving a lot of questions on the orders or the stranded inventory. Please reach out to the seller support team. We come from the catalog experience team and we would not be able to appropriately address this request or suggest to please go to the seller support. There's a question from Sanjay on the changes on bullet point title and A plus details. So I'll take this one. We definitely do not make changes to the A plus content. This goes to our moderation exercise as we just walked you, where Anusha did share with you some of the guidelines rejection reasons. We only accept or reject whatever is happening on the A plus content. Coming to the title, bullet point, and product description, if at all any changes are made by Amazon, they are in direct correlation to what we have on the style guide. We do not create the information. We will use your information to restructure the information to make it more concise. This is something you will be able to see on the catalog defect report recommendations as well.
So continuing on that question, there is also a query on what we upload images. Also, images which we upload are not reflecting in the sequence that we had updated. This is a very peculiar question. Can you please reach out to the seller support and provide us the details? We would like to investigate into it.
There is one question on what is text tab delimited. That is a format of saving Excel file. So once you fill the bulk template and you click on save as, you get that option. That is a simpler option which Amazon systems use to understand the information that you are sharing. So whenever you are doing a bulk upload, you're expected to save the file in this format and then do the upload.
Okay, Rupesh has a question on, can you guide us more on how we can include a video in our listing? So currently uploading videos in your images is available to brand registered sellers. If you are a brand registered seller, please reach out to your respective account manager. He will help you do that. Video links should be in a Dropbox link or a Google link. It should not be a YouTube video link.
Okay, there's a question from Hiran from product description only seen on desktop but not on the mobile devices. Product description will be visible on both the spaces as long as you don't have an A plus content. When the A plus content comes in, it takes over the product description. The placement of it is little downward on the mobile display. That's the only difference in the two experiences. The session is being recorded and all of you will get a recording for it.
So there's a question on where I can find which of my ASINs are applicable for A+. Any ASIN that you own or have an offer on is eligible for A+ content.
There's a question again on videos on A+. This is part of the premium A+ experience. Currently open only to select premium sellers, but we will look. We don't have the visibility of when we are going to look into opening it up. So till then, I recommend to use the current modules available.
There is a question from Bhaskar. He is talking about how they do a partial assembly of their units in India. However, and the brand name or the company name has India as part of, the entire name. So the country of origin attribute, right, it is not related to trademark or company or anything of that sort. However, in this case, if you're wondering what to update in country of origin because you do partial assembly of the products in India, our recommendation is to reach out to your legal counsel, get a confirmation of them on what should be the appropriate value and update it accordingly.
There's again a question on the unit count for pack of three from Divya. This is a very common question on the combo listings. It's important that you mention unit as one, but everything which is part of it, you can surface it in your title or in the bullet point. In this example, a pack of three could come in your bullet point, but the unit, the quantity should only be one. And it could be a combination of a top and a bottom. So the components included in the product, you can have a bullet point like that to explain that.
So there's a question on how frequently we get the catalog defect report in seller panel. You will get the catalog defect report on a weekly basis if your ASIN falls under the defective list. There are a lot of questions around seller support not reaching out or resolving queries immediately. So we have provided an alternate email ID where you can send us your queries, which is in-catalog-queries@amazon.com. We will share this email list with you. Please do also raise your queries on this particular email ID so that we can personally look into it.
There's a question again on Hiran from on the approval timelines on the A+ content. We typically take 7 working days. So that is normal. This would exclude the weekends, which would be Saturdays and Sundays.
There's a question by Vishwa on the character limitation on A+ product description. So there's no limitation as such. Like I explained, keep it crisp and product relevant, and you can use as many characters as you want based on that.
There is one question by Divya on updating manufacturer name and address. While a lot of sellers feel that it is confidential and they do not want to share it, however, it is a legal requirement. This is not something Amazon is asking. This is something that is required from the Legal Metrology Act. So this is part of government regulation, and you are expected to provide the manufacturer name and contact information and the accurate manufacturer name and contact information for all your listings.
Okay, there's a question on, are videos not allowed through YouTube uploads? How else can we do, please? So if you are asking for uploading videos in the image section, YouTube links are not allowed. There are various tools available online from which you can download YouTube uploads and then upload it in a share it in a Dropbox link or a Google Drive link. YouTube uploads are definitely directly not allowed.
Okay, there are a couple of questions on the Amazon fee from Anuj and from Dharan. So I'll just take a quick one on this. The categorization has got a relationship to your commission fee. You have to make sure that the product path, as I shared on my presentation, is accurate for your product. And if that is not matching to the referral fee, again, please reach out to Seller Central and you can call it out specifically that your product has got the right category, but still the fee is not charged right, and they will take it to the respective team.
So for there's a question on 360 degree images. So right now we are coming up with a feature for 360 degree images. However, it will be available to everyone in phases. But to solve this problem, you can create a video around it. But to upload that video, you should be a brand registered seller. If you are a brand registered seller, please reach out to your respective AM, and he can help you out with uploading the 360 degree images in a video format.
So there are a lot of questions revolving around being a authorized reseller. So in that case, what you can do is you can gain secondary access to A+ and you can create content for your product.
Okay, there's one more thing which we have enabled as the cataloging team. Because we did get this continuous feedback on our different seller connects that the responses from seller support are not, how do I say, complete, and it leads to a lot of rework at your end. Purely for the catalog related queries, and this is the topics that we have covered today, you can reach out to us on in-catalog-queries@amazon.com. I just want to emphasize, we will not address inventory, order, buy box related questions on this group. If you are having challenges with the listing which falls around the detail page domain, you can write to us directly and we will respond to you. There's a question from Vijay on the seller account management. Vijay, there are different services that Amazon offers for managed account. These are paid services. Again, you can reach out to seller support to choose the kind of engagement you would want to do, and they provide consultation on different streams, from pricing to the kind of catalog that you should be maintaining, and take it forward from there.
There are a couple of questions around creating variations. So you can create variations either through the OneCrossOne user interface or through bulk upload. However, if you want to know the specifics on it, there are some help pages and videos on Seller Central help section and Seller University section. Please do go through them. If you have further questions, we would recommend you to reach out to the seller support and seek their assistance in creating variations for your ASINs.
There's a question from Surekha on changing of title and the notes for the products. I'll take this one. Again, as I said, for title, any changes that we do from Amazon is to bring the title in line with the style guides. On the categorization, because we have observed that there's a lot of products which are miscategorized, there are automated models which try to identify the right category for your product, and that could be the reason for the changes. If you are finding it that it is inappropriate, you can write to us for the categorization changes, again to us on the catalog queries amazon.com, or you can also raise a request to seller support.
There's a question on by Samida, where she asks, suppressed issues we are facing for many ASIN. Like Anirban has already answered to you, reach out to us on in_catalog-queries@amazon.com for further investigation. However, we would like to call out that ASINs are actioned upon only when they do not follow the Amazon guidelines. So please ensure your ASINs follow all imaging and all other catalog guidelines for sure.
We do not allow phone numbers or external URLs on our product detail page. As Animesh explained, very soon these rules are going to come during the ASIN creation stage itself. Today we try to manually remove them, but in future this is going to get blocked right at the creation timeline.
There's a question from Divya. Which is, we have followed image dimensions, even then our images look smaller compared to other sellers. How can we fix it? So answering to that, Divya, it is highly unlikely that it would happen because this is, the process is entirely automated. But however, if you are still facing this issue, please do drop in a note on seller support or in the email ID that we have already mentioned. There's a question on keywords. So keywords should be separated by space and not by commas. And including keywords in description will be helpful. Of course, it will, you know, add, have an incremental advantage of definitely. But it is important to mention all your keywords within the keyword field itself.
There's a lot of questions on listing variations. I would request you all to reach out to us on catalog queries with a specific case and we can help you resolve it on a one-on-one basis.
There is this question on what is a twister listing through which a variation of a product can be shown. Basically, twister is the themes on which you can show the variation. For example, it can be multiple sizes of the same product. It can be a combination of multiple sizes and multiple colors of the same product. So the different themes of variation is essentially what is called as a twister listing.
There is a question from Surekha regarding title, description and route notes getting changed for her catalog and no appropriate resolution from Seller Central. So I think it has been answered. You can drop in the details at in/catalog/queries@amazon.com so that we can further investigate. But just so that you know it better, there can be several reasons why title, description and other attributes might change. It can have a defect and our internal teams might take an action on them. Or if that same product is being sold by several sellers, Amazon has a system in place in which it tries to determine which seller has provided the best information for which particular attribute. So from your question, if your bullet point remains unchanged, it might be your particular contribution to the bullet point was the best, but someone else who is selling the same product has a better title and a better description, and hence their particular data is being populated on Amazon.
Okay, there's a question from Hiran Lal, which is it mandatory to provide search terms while listing a product? It is not mandatory, but it is definitely recommended to provide search terms while listing a product. It will only help that into for the discoverability of your ASINs.
So Vijay, HTML tags are not allowed on the bullet point. If you would use this, your products would be prone to action by the internal Amazon team. We do not allow HTML either on the product description bullet point or the A plus section. We strongly suggest to not use this on your listings anywhere.
So to add on to that, Vijay, if you need formatting on your product description or bullet points, just type in the exact format that you would like and Amazon would make sure that internally HTML tags are generated, but no external HTML tags are allowed when you try to list a product.
So Anuj, you have a question on editing the listing created by others. You would use it the same way as you would edit your own listings. If you are finding it that your edits are not coming on the detail page, and what has been provided by or what is currently displaying is inaccurate or incomplete, you can write to us and we can help in surfacing the right information on the front page. As Animesh mentioned, there are certain technical issues related to which seller's contribution comes to the front of it, and it might not be straightforward resolved, but we can look into it in case there's an inaccuracy or incompleteness on the information.
So answering to your question, Vinay, if you want to know why your image has been removed, please reach out to seller support. If like you said, they are not able to provide any resolution, since you are a brand registered seller, you can also reach out to your account manager escalating this issue, or reach out to us on the email ID shared above.
Surekha, please write to us and we'll look into this. If there has been a categorization issues which are not being addressed, we can help you out with that. So Pavitra has a question on a use case where she's not able to update a brand name in the keywords section. This is not going to give you any benefit on your product discovery, Pavitra. We do not recommend to use any brand names in the search keywords. As again, as it has got no benefit in your indexing. So you can avoid using that, and that will eliminate the need of making changes. Yes, Pavitra, even that won't be allowed. There's a question on duplicate listing. We do acknowledge there are currently a very big issue on the duplicate ASINs on the platform. We are working, as and when these ASINs are identified, our internal team, this is not the cataloging team, but a different team which does the merging of these products into a single product. There is currently no straightforward solution. If you are observing again a duplicate listing, please write to seller support and this would get resolved. Okay, we'll take maybe one or two questions more. Okay, so what I would request all of you is there's going to be a feedback form at the end of this session where you can share your thoughts, any other topics that you would like us to cover, and any questions which have remained unanswered pertaining to the cataloging space, you can write to us. Seller performance team, Manoj, again, seller support is your best try to reach out to them. Is all I would say. So with that note, again, thank you everyone for your time. And I hope that this session was helpful for you to being able to list the right catalog for your products.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. Please ensure that you fill the feedback form which you will get at the end of this presentation. Thank you once again.
Thank you for that, Sonal. So hello, fellows. We have come to the end of today's session. I would like to thank the entire Catalog team to take their time off and address all of you and explain to us on every aspect of Catalog in a very thoroughly manner. With that, like Sonal rightly said, there will be a feedback form that you all will be receiving onto your registered email ID. You will be receiving the recorded session of the webinar as well, along with some of the important links that you all saw on the screen, which I will be sharing with all of you. Do go through that whenever you all have some time. With that, thank you for participating in today's session. It was great training you all, and I wish you all a happy Sunday going forward. Thanks, all of you.